All right.
Vedufel, even the name means bad weather, where frozen wind sweeps in from the bay. They tend livestock, but most are just men driven from strand with nowhere else to go. Why else would anyone stay? We won't stop long.
All right, we're coming into town. Look at all of our men. He'll give us a chance to spend... I know renown is pretty much your currency as well, so you can buy some supplies. Buy Hodderborg. That's a lot of varl for some missing cattle. What? A couple days back, sent word to Strand about the cattle. Didn't expect an army. He looked pleased with himself until it sinks in that you aren't here on his behalf. Where have your cattle gone? Well, wouldn't know. My boy's seen men up the hills carrying them away. Don't know many men who can hoist a whole cow by himself. Scafflings out there, maybe? Could they have a varl working for them? Not from what the governor told me. I'm going to take a look around and get camp set up. The peasant spits, his eyes anxiously darting about as the caravan sets up tents. We'll be here no more than a day. There's silver for any food you've got. For hundreds of varl? Are you serious? Whatever you're willing to sell. You thinking of squatting? Not enough room for a couple hunters here. Forget hundreds of... Shut up. Hear that? Where's Luton? It's faint. Sounds like fighting and... something else. Hakon takes off at a run. Ooh! Fighting. So yeah, this is going to be mostly blind. And feel free to yell at me and tell me how much I suck. I won't listen. Oh, what? Okay. Oh, I can make waypoints? When you need to avoid certain tiles. Okay, that's good to know. No, I don't want to move there. I don't want to get next to him. Why are you making me get next to him? Can I refuse? I guess not. Jesus, dude. Spearmen can attack, diagonally and up to two tiles away. Press tab or click the top right banner to compare your stats with the enemies. He is a lot tougher than me. Luton? The prince is gonna die. Oh no. Okay. Armor blocks attacks on strength. So once this gets down, for each point that the enemy is higher, there's a 10% chance the attack will be deflected. What's the chance to hit shown above the attack item? Attack the enemy! Why? I want to do this! Oh my god. And I can't spend my willpower, so this is all still tutorial mode. Yeah, see, look, he deflected. They do no damage. From here on out, you will fail catastrophically if you do not break armor. Damaging both strength and armor is equally important. And, oh my god. Holy shit. Hi. Alright, so... what are their movement? Alright, they won't get there in time. We need to take this mother down. Okay. Rest? No. Alright, Sundering Impact. 100% to hit, plus 1 strength, plus 1 break target, plus 1 break to heavy impact. Alright. Let's move. Yeah, we're gonna just surround him. And if the shield's on this side, it'll make it a lot easier with these guys. So, let's break his armor. Okay. Oh, I won't be able to get to him in time. So, I am going to have to just line up right there. Nope. And turn. Here comes this guy. Shit. Alright. Well, we can at least move to here. Tempest is gonna do shit. We can still hurt his health, but I think we want to break his armor. And he's going for my health, that son of a bitch. There we go. Now I think we can hurt him. Oh no, but you've got to get out of the way. Oh shit. Okay, that was a misclick. That's fine. Alright. You need to... 7. And 8. Yeah, no, you need to move away. You're too hurt. You'll have to come in later, dude. Oh, he's chasing after me. God damn it. Okay. Alright. Bring the pain. Break damage to target, plus 1 to return the favor. So, No, we're not... Just gonna attack as per usual. We gotta just weaken him some more. He is big. Alright. 30% chance. Yeah, you're very nearly dead. Just break his armor, man. I think. Oh! Is he running? What is he doing? What is he doing? If you could stop him from doing that, that would be great. Oh, thank God. No! Okay. Shit, now he's in my way. Alright, you need to use your willpower. And stop him. Whenever enemy... One willpower stars added to your horn using the horn will give 1 willpower to activate ability, and there goes my guy. Okay, we are going to just wail on this guy, I suppose. And we're going to wail on his armor. Bring the pain. Wait. There we go. Okay, that did something. That sure did do something. Now we have the possibility of deflection. I have to weaken both of these guys. Yep, good. Alright. Knock down their health. There we go. Promoted. Pillage mode. There we go. Yikes, although, victory. Mogar is ready for promotion. That's good. And we got 5 renown. But the prince and my bodyguard, the one in the green thing that made him look like a frog, he got hurt. You trying to get yourself killed, Luden? What are you doing? I was trying to get a shot in between the plates. You've never seen a dredge before, boy? What kind of idiot break their armor first. Where did they come from? We didn't even see them. They were just there. Hakon goes to where Vognir lies face down. The future Varl King lies motionless, aside from a spreading pool of blood. Vognir's dead. Chapter 2. Cut with keen-edged sword. Great. That's just awesome. So now we get to go to the cap. No, not even. Ah, alright. A new chapter. I see different characters. Ooh. Where did that thing come from? Shh, stay close. I think it saw us. Deployment happens before battle. Click on your characters, Rook and Alette, and move them anywhere within the blue squares. Click ready. When I'm ready. 7 out of 7, what are you? 8 out of 10. He is 9 out of 8. Oh, we're going to weaken him before he comes in with his hatchet. Does one arm damage, and all allies within range automatically attack the target. Huh. And what do you do? Puncture? Both damage to targets who have lost armor if the archer has not moved. Thread the needle. Hit all units between the archer. Okay, so we want to go as far away as possible. So here. And, you protect her, dude. Alright. Careful, don't get too close. No shit. Alright. Bonus damage to armor if she hasn't moved, but we've done no damage to that yet. Oh, shit. Mark prey. That's not within range. Okay, that's fine. And here he comes. Okay, you still have... Oh, you gotta be within a certain range. Oh shit, I might have just cornered myself. Alright, well, we'll see. Let's see where this guy goes chasing. Who he chases after. We still have one turn. That's good. No, I might have to want to move from there. To weaken him a little bit with you, but now you're gonna get hit. So we're gonna do this, and then attack your armor, and use all your willpower. Hit him for 2, good. And yeah, you were gonna do that. Yikes. After her, huh? Well, that'll weaken you. Alright, finish him off, hon. Beauty! Alright. That was a little sloppy, but whatever, new system. 3 renown for killing one ugly Varg. Dredge. Was that a dredge? Alette looks calm, but you can tell her heart is about a beat right out of her chest. It was. Let me see. Are you hurt? No, I'll be fine. When the dredge attacked your cart and the yawks bolted, it spilled most of your supplies. You can see more dark figures moving through trees when you glance that direction. All that food. That's the last we're going to get before winter. What do we do? Don't run. Let me think. If we hurry, we can gather them before more dredge appears. Yeah, we'll just have to be quick. I can see them in the trees. Are you sure about this? No, we have to try. Be quick! Yeah. If those are our only supplies before winter, we gotta go for it. Alec calms the yawks while you frantically toss supplies back into the cart. More dredge emerge, but you manage to get the cart moving again before they can close in. The colossal figures slowly recede into the distance. Whew, that was close. Plus 15 supplies. Good. Supplies represent food and other goods used to keep everyone alive on the road. When supplies are gone, people will start to die of starvation. The more people are in the caravan, the faster supplies will diminish. Obvious. You can see how many days of supplies you have left on the travel display at the top of the screen. Most towns will have supplies to sell as well as a few items. Alright. We're traveling. Off we go. Normal morale, 17 days of supplies, because it's only just the two of us. Look at this. Oh, Stogir. Isn't this beautiful? It's effing beautiful, guys. Well, now we're closing in, I think. Yeah.
I never expected to see the dredge with my own eyes. What happened in the north? Already we see more between the trees as we approach our home, and Alette grips my hand tight. We must find Ivar.
Ivar? We go. Small little, well, it's really just a couple buildings, really, isn't it? Ivar! The enormous Varl in question towers over the men in the training field. He squints as you approach. Already back, Huntmaster. Thought you'd be tomorrow. Dredge everywhere. Dredge? How did they get through Greyhorn? Must have broken through the fort. The fighters nearby have stopped sparring. They gather around you. Damn it! They'll be here soon, if not already. You hear screams. From the outskirts, people are running towards the Great Hall. Ivar turns to one of the older boys in this group of fighters. Eagle, take Alette to the Great Hall. Tell the chieftain what's happening. The rest of you, gather up as many people as you can. Come on, Alette.
No, wait, I want to help.
Yes, let them fight Ivar. I have a feeling we're going to need every single person we can. Why not invite some goats to join us too? You're asking for dead kids. I won't let anything happen to her. They'll have to deal with it sooner or later, Ivar. What now? Eagle, keep your shield up. We'll just hold them off until everyone's inside, then we'll figure out what to do next. More shouts draw your attention to some houses atop a nearby hill. Oh boy. Uh, Here we go. Houses. And I think this is a great time to take a break. We'll catch you again next time.